You could go to the movies on a date, but it is so hard to get the man and the woman to agree on what a good movie is. Women will always tell you, why don't men like a romantic movie? False. Men love a romantic movie. A certain kind. Porno. Yes. Porno is the romance movie for men. To a guy, porno is a beautiful love story with the boring parts taken out. See, because it's like this. It's like, let's say this is the men and this is the women. What gets the men excited in the movies is goofy guy stuff like cars and guns and aliens and breasts and explosions and aliens with big exploding breasts. Women's movies are more sophisticated. Women have a technique in the movies they like. What's the word for the thing that women... Talking. There's a lot of talking. A lot of talking and yakking and yearning for a love that can never be. And as far as the men are concerned, wasting valuable killing and fornication time. So, ladies and gentlemen, how can we get a movie out there that is strong enough for the man, yet made for the woman? Lucky for you, I'm free all day in the hotel, and I've been working on one. It's called Waiting to Exhale.
With a vengeance.
Here's the men, here's the women, here's the plot. Watch how everybody winds up happy. Okay, movie starts. A group of bad guys take over a public place. They're gonna kill the hostages unless their evil, horrible demands are met. And all the men go, sounds like a good movie. Dun-dun-dun. For some reason, this whole evil plot is unfolding in a very upscale shopping center. Ding-ding-ding-ding. What the bad guys don't know is the pissed off, hard drinking super cop Bruce Willis is in the shopping center. Da-dan. Dealing with his upcoming divorce by getting totally wasted in the bar at Hooters. Da-dan. What Bruce doesn't know is that his wife is right now a hostage in the temporary command post of the bad guys. Victoria's Secret. Ding, 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 ding. Ding, ding. Okay. And Bruce Willis's wife is really hot, guys. She's got a butt that's too big and her hair's really long in the back, so if you want to make love to her, you could fantasize that she's like a pony, and then you... All right, that's just me. All right, now. Okay. The FBI shuts off the electricity and the mall goes pitch black. Dun-dun. The bad guys respond by lighting 600 lavender candles they got from Bed Bath & Beyond. Da-da-da-da-ding. Three, the chase scene. Bruce Willis hops into a sports car, a brand new Dodge Viper, dun-dun, with a lighted vanity mirror on the passenger side. Ding-ding-ding. And there's a high-speed chase through the shopping center, first through the sharper image, dun-dun, then through Crabtree and Evelyn. Ding-ding. On into Neiman Marcus, where they see that girl that sprays you with a cologne when you come in, bam, they plow into where she goes flying. Dun-dun, ding-ding. All right, now, end of the movie, Bruce Willis and his wife reconcile, and they have really hot sex, dun-dun. But first, they have foreplay, ding. For an hour, ding! And the wife is so happy, she says, the heck with cuddling and talking, let's put on that football game! Dun 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 dun! Kickoff! Freeze frame! Credits! There you go.